moving farther and farther to the right and has really left us in a situation where it's had driven a race to the bottom. And thank you. What we're seeing now is decades of their policies of imperialism, of neoliberalism, that have created the situation that we're in today, where so many voters are feeling economically insecure. And part of the reason that we're seeing such high rates of people not voting is that why should they vote? Our democracy is a mirage. The candidates are pre-chosen, both basically by Wall Street powers, money wins, and you know, they see the game, it's not benefiting them, so why turn out and vote? And I think it really created a situation where in this last election, people just said, well, we'll vote for whoever is, you know, not the establishment, because maybe that'll bring us the change that we need. I think people are just really frustrated. Is that if we really look at their policies, they fall within a very narrow spectrum, and I'm not telling you anything new. Their economic, their foreign policies are really in a very small spectrum. The debate is in that very small spectrum, and it actually falls outside of where the majority of people are. But they're really used to generate fear on both sides and cause us to constantly be divided and fighting down here when really we need to be looking at what's going on at a much higher level. So how do we get out of that? I mean, social transformation, in my view, is going to happen outside of the corporate duopoly parties. And it's going to come by building an independent political movement that is radical and that sees its role clearly as being in opposition to the corporate duopoly parties. Now, in an ideal world, I think that we would see coalitions of parties on the left at the national, state, and local level, learning how to work together and support each other and to actually augment each other, share our resources so that we can make sure that we win some of these races. At the national level, you know, I really questioned what would be the best approach. The Green Party at the national level has a fairly good infrastructure. They were able to get on the majority of states' ballots in this last year. There are some definite weaknesses within the Green Party, but the choice is between starting from scratch, which we know can take a very long time to build up the infrastructure at the national level, or we can try to see if we can move the Green Party to be in a more independent and radical and oppositional position. And so that's what we decided to do in 2016. And in terms of how do we get there, one thing I think we need to understand is that our target audience in building a radical opposition party are the non-voters. So often we're trying to convince the Democrats to come to our side. And the reality is the majority of people in the country are neither Democrats nor Republicans. And the majority of people in the country don't vote. And so how do we reach those communities? And part of it is by having a very bold vision and taking bold stands, bold positions and policy. Because people are with us. I mean, they want single-payer health care. They want an end to these wars. They want safe communities and public education and affordable housing and safe food to eat. So, and really dealing with the climate crisis. So we need to really be out there and stating that these are the things that we stand for and not compromising in our stances to draw people out. It's also really important that we go into communities that are typically marginalized and develop relationships and support their leadership so that it is the communities that have traditionally been left out the most who are rising up and running, you know, for office. And we're trying to do that in Baltimore. And we need to be really clear that we are in opposition to the corporate duopoly parties. You know, we need to constantly be criticizing and calling them out for their behavior. Part of that is political education, so that people understand how our system works or doesn't work. And a couple more thoughts. I think really important, and we're trying to do this in the Green Party at the local level and at the marginalized communities. And we do this in our social movement work as well. Really important to you know, we open each of our direct training camps with an anti-oppression training so that people have that understanding going into the training camp, and it makes it generally work out a lot better. We need to do that in our parties too. We need to be understanding how white supremacy works, how systemic racism works, how oppression works, and how we can work to dismantle that and address that and make our communities communities that really can support people who have typically been marginalized. And also really important is to develop structures of accountability, because we know that as we get stronger, we're going to have the forces at hand coming in and trying to disrupt us. And without structures of accountability, processes, and you know, safeguards, then it's very easy for those forces to come in and send a party, you know, right off track. So we need to have those as well. I think that it is an imperative right now for us to build this independent opposition party. We're not going to see the changes that we need until we do that. I'm sure I don't have to tell you that it's not going to be easy to do this work, but there is no shortcut to doing what we need to do to start to create the social transformation that we need.